Howdy. We're playing Zombicide Black Plague again. This time we're on Quest 8, the Evil Temple. It's listed as hard, but after looking over the mission rules and seeing that there's only 3 spawn zones on the board, I don't think it's going to be too bad, but we'll see what I think after I've played it. Objectives: Exorcism, Survivor Style, Zombicide. Take both vault weapons and kill the abomination to win the game. Since some of my characters can get to 3 damage, I chose the abomination that I'm putting in the vault to be the troll. That way he can only be killed with bile and fire. Setup. Put the blue and green objectives randomly among the red objectives face down. Put aside the dragon bile and torch cards. Set 1 dragon bile and 1 torch card in the yellow vault. Put 2 random vault artifacts in the violet vault. Destroying the cursed idol. Idols. Each objective gives 5 experience to the survivor who takes it. Caches. The violet vault door cannot be opened until the blue objective has been taken. The yellow vault door cannot be opened until the green objective has been taken. So I have to get into the yellow vault first to get the weapons to kill the troll. And then I will need the blue objective to get into the violet vault. So, like I said, I think this mission's going to end up being one of my easier missions, but we'll see how I feel about it when I finish up. So, these are the 2 biggest rooms. Buildings. I'm planning to spawn those fairly early. And we're just going to see how this runs. So, let's get started. Turn 1, it looks like I'm going to be doing mainly just walking. So, I'm going to go ahead and start moving. I do want to get into those big buildings first. So let's see. 1, 2, open the door. I don't have to roll because she's wielding an axe. That's why I love this character. Now I have to spawn this entire building. That was her 3 actions. Alright, so we're gonna work our way around like that. First, we get a double spawn. That double spawn is going to lead into 2 spawns here. Let's get those out. An abomatrol gets a free turn, but he can't go anywhere because he's locked up. Nothing in sight, so nothing happened there. And then we get 1 walker. That should be not too bad to deal with. The blue level's really nice. Alright, here we get 1 extra activation, no one. But remember, when I'm playing with Ostakar, he gets a free turn every time an extra activation happens. So we're going to go ahead and go 1, 2, 3. Going to go ahead and get in the building. We hope nothing bad happens. And that doesn't count as their turn. And walkers don't get the runners don't get the extra activation because there's none here. And we're in the blue level. So that was pretty awesome. All right, this room, let's see what we get. Here we get 1 NPC at random. Here we get 4 in sight. I was about to say 4 walkers. Here we get 1 extra activation, all fatties. This is working out pretty good for me with her extra activation. Oh, let's go ahead and put the sound token over here. She's going to move 1, 2, and take the objective. It's the green objective. We can get into the yellow vault already. That's amazing. And she gets 5 experience for doing that. So 1, 2, objective. And when she actually gets her real turn, she'll try to torch that zombie. All right. For the final room over here, we get an abomination, so nothing. Because of how the cards were stacked, the game's going very quickly. So hopefully we'll be able to keep going with that. Alright, next what we're going to go ahead and do is somebody else that hasn't taken a turn. Clovis is going to go open this building. Let's go ahead and just get the objectives and call this game done. So he's going to try to open that door. So this is his third action. He succeeds. He knocks open the door. And we have to spawn. So if you want to see what Clovis is wielding before I spawn, he's got 2 short swords. Let's go ahead and spawn for this room right in front of him. We get 1 runner. For the next room, we're going to get an abomator, so nothing. When you're playing with the extra stuff, like the bosses and stuff, if the bosses come up early game, it looks like it's going to be a really easy game. But then when they come up, when you actually level, it starts making you want to cry. So I've actually only moved two characters so far, because Ostakar got two free turns. So let's go ahead and move somebody else. Let's try to put down that zombie. One, two. And let's see. Genevieve's going to take a shot at it. Three or higher. She gets a kill. So she gets one experience point, and that runner's gone, and so is her turn. All right. Anne is going to move one, two, three. She's going to start heading to the yellow vault. And Julian is going to start heading there as well. One, two, three. All of our player turns are done. Oh, wait. No, they're not. I have one character left. It always feels like I've moved Ostakar when he gets those free turns. We're going to blow up this zombie that's on us. We get three chances. First chance, miss. Second chance, miss. Third chance, hit. Let's make sure that's a good. A die will balance on it, so we're good. We made three noise. And we got a kill. So that he's going to go ahead and keep this. So he's got one interesting zombie on his dashboard. So one more experience and I'll be in yellow, which will be scary. But this mission's going hyper well. We're going to go ahead and run spawns. So when we run spawns, we'll start way over there. We get one walker. All right. Next, we get one NPC. For our final spawn point, oh, zombies had to move. I forgot there's a zombie still on the board. All right, we get one NPC. All right, that concludes the zombie turn. And this stuff's just not too scary right now. I could go ahead and level up, but that doesn't seem super smart. So she might just walk away from that thing. I don't know. Let's see how everybody else does. Alright, Genevieve will want to level later, so I'm going to go ahead and move her. Well, no, let's let Clovis do that. Clovis is going to be the one to take the first turn. So Clovis is going to move one, two, grab. And it's not the objective we're looking for. Gets five experience. That's his turn. Genevieve is going to move one, two, shoot this zombie. She succeeds. She gets an experience point. And she collects one zombie for her dashboard. All right, we've taken care of them. Now let's go ahead and see who else we can get activated. Anne's going to charge over here. So she was here. That's Bloodlust, so she's already on that zombie. She succeeds, she gets a kill. So Anne went ahead and got our kill. That's one experience. Now she's going to attempt to open up a door. There's no sound there. So she's going to try to open up this big room. She succeeds. She made one sound in doing so, and we get to spawn something in that room. What we're going to spawn is one runner. So that could hurt because it'll move onto the cell, then attack me. Julian can't get over in there at that time. So she's going to back up one step. Although I really want to open that door. We're going to go ahead and take the wound. I want to get this going. So she's going to try to open up the other door. Can she do it? No, but she made another sound. Julian's going to run over here. He's going to try to open up the door. Success. So this door breaks open. Hey, mark who's went. Anne's went. Julian's went as well. He moved up, did his one attack on the door. I still have two characters left to go. But first, I need to spawn that entire building. So the first room is going to be a double spawn. The next room spawns twice. So the room I actually want to get into, an abominator, so nothing, and two NPC zombies. Right now this hard mission's looking super easy. Okay, and a fatty in the back. That's a little bit more work. Alright, she needs to go open up things. So I gotta get into the yellow vault because everybody else is collecting all the objectives for me. So she's gonna move 1, 2, 3. I'm torn. I could kill that zombie and get experience and make the game super interesting, but I'm not sure we can handle a super interesting game right now. But it looks like I'm almost done, and y'all know me. I'm gonna go ahead and kill it. I always make poor decisions about holding back on leveling. So let's go ahead and get to level 2. And then watch me start pulling all the bosses. So attack, 4, success, he gets a kill, it's a normal zombie. I get an experience point. We now spawn yellows, which really wasn't a smart move. But hey, I'm having fun, I like doing it, so I think we're good. Alright, next move, fourth move. So now things are about to get scary. And I probably shouldn't have done that, but y'all know me, I can never control leveling up. It's just fun seeing scary stuff on the board. Alright, so everybody wants to go that way. 1, 2, I gotta take out a bite of somebody. It's gonna be Anne this time. So Anne gets a bite. These guys move closer. The fatty moves closer. This one moves closer. And there's nothing on the other side of the board. Now we run spawns. We'll start with the far end. 2 NPCs now. Alright, way over here, on top of my characters, is going to spawn a necromancer. In addition to the necromancer, he also brings a spawn. This spawn will generate another draw. That draw is going to be 2 fatties. Now I'm kind of starting to get a little more scared. I got a lot of stuff in that cell, and I'm not sure I can deal with it. And they're stuck there. So maybe this is a bad move. I should really learn some self-control. One runner. But, you know, I lose a lot of people every mission, so if they die, they die. We're back to the player turn now. And things are definitely already more interesting. I have 2 fatties, I got a lot of stuff to deal with. Life's starting to look pretty rough. I think we may just have to throw everything into that cell and hope we can get some kills. So, I guess Julian's gonna go first, because he has the hammer. And he's going to throw 3 dice with his hammer. He's trying to kill those fatties. That'll make everything softer and easier for everybody else. Come on. Ooh, wow. 2 kills. He got both fatties. All right. That's a really good start. All right. So he's good. That runner and necro definitely need to go down. Julian's done. I feel pretty good about what he just did there. Anne is going to go ahead and throw her... Does she have 3 dice? Yeah, 3 dice. She hits once. This is a hard call. Do I take out the necro or the runner? I'm going to go with the necro. I know that's going to get me some wounds, but I just don't want another spawn zone on us. So Anne, let me put her card over there for you. Succeeded in killing a necromancer. And she gets 1 experience point for that. I always thought necros should be worth more. They're pretty scary. Alright. So her turn is done. Julian's done. My girl with the axe that opens doors is going to go 1, 2. She's going to make an attempt at that runner. Come on. Nope. Nothing there. So... It looks like I'm going to get bit a lot. So now what we need to do is let's go ahead and activate Genevieve. I'm contemplating going over there and casting a spell into there and hoping I don't hit my friends. But before I do anything super dumb, let Genevieve go. She attacks that runner, kills it, gets one experience. And she's gonna start making her way down the alley. One, two. That's all she's got left. Clovis is bored. One, two, three. He's done as well. This noise is gone from the previous turn. All right. So the only person I have left is my mage. She's gonna move one, two, three. Now, do I take the shot and try to do some glory and maybe hurt my friends and make this a lot worse next turn? Or do I just wait and take a wound for people? She's gonna throw the magic. She's got to. Boom! Oh no! Isabel, no! Let's see. I had a wound already on Isabel. I think I removed it from last game because she hasn't been. All she's done is open doors and walk. So I messed that up. I forgot to reset her to zero. So Isabel and Anne now both have wounds. Don't remember what Anne took a wound from. Oh, the runner that was there. She took a wound from Anne. Isabel hasn't taken a wound before this. She just took her first wound. And we're done with the player turn. The first thing we do is we hand out wounds on that cell. Oh, Stockar takes one wound, and Julian takes one wound. That's from the runner. And these guys move up. The fatty moves up. They're all heading towards that sound. And now we spawn. So way over here, we're getting an abomatrol. So the fun stuff is on the board already. So there we get an abomatrol. And over on top of us, we get one fatty. That's doable. No, wait. Yeah, one fatty because we're in yellow. Over here, we get a necromancer. I can handle dealing with a necromancer again. But he gets to spawn an extra thing. As long as it's not an A-bomb, we're in good shape. And that's going to be three NPCs. I'm not sure I can deal with that. Alright, random NPCs. Looks like they're all of different sculpts. That's good. So we are done spawning. Now players get to go. Yeah. Not go as well. The spawns aren't going super great for me right now. Alright, Clovis is going to move forward. And then he's going to wait. Just to make sure he has the correct backup, I'm going to go one, two, I don't know. I'm here. One, two, three. She can't open the door, unfortunately. But at least she can attract some zombies away from everything that's going on over there. I got the green objective, but I don't have the blue one. All right. So we're back to the player turn. Right, the first thing we got to do is get rid of that fatty. So Julian's going to go ahead and activate. And he's going to throw a lot of dice, and he hopes he takes down the fatty. This is old. He misses every time. He's performing like he did last game. All right. Next, I'm going to go ahead and activate Isabel, and she's going to swing her axe three times. She gets two kills. She's going to take the runner and one of the NPC walkers, getting her two experience. As long as I can thin these waves out, things will get pretty good. Because I got a lot of people there that I don't want taking a lot of wounds. All right. Anne's gonna borrow. borrow the hammer. She's going to give Julian the sword. She's going to borrow the hammer and then attack twice because we got to put that fatty down. All right, she's going to get two attacks with the hammer. Come on. She killed the fatty. So that makes things a little better. All right, so Anne is done. Genevieve's done. Clovis is done. Ostakar is not done. Ostakar's first action is going to be to trade Mana Blast for a short sword. So he's got three actions left. So she's going to throw three dice trying to take out that NPC. She succeeds, and she collects another NPC for her board. Now she's got two sculpts, three more, and she gets an artifact. Alright, and I also get an experience point for doing that. Alright, I guess we're moving into the zombie turn. This fatty moves forward. This one has 1, 2, 3, 4, but the most noise is that way. These move here. Let me double check the rule on the Minotaur, because I messed it up last game. So I should have that. I don't know if he wants to move to the noisiest, or if he wants to move to the closest. Abominators can smash through walls when they move, set their target zone before moving them, ignoring closed walls, blah, 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 blah. Okay, so we set the target zone, which is what the normal zone would be. He can't see her, so this is the closest. So he'd follow the normal rules. For noise, I believe. He still wants to go to these noise. Didn't specify too much, so we set the target zone. Set the target zone before moving them, ignoring doors and walls. If an abomination has to go through a closed door first, blah, 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 blah. All right. Target zone. That one's a little iffy, so what I'm going with, he follows normal rules. He wants to go that way, but he would ignore the closest path. He would ignore the walls. But next time, he sees this one, because that's the rules he's following. All right, so these guys move here. So we're all done. Now what we need to do is activate all these spawn points. So all my people might get stuck on that spawn point again. Okay, we get an abomination way over here. So the map's getting pretty scary, like it does every game, because I have no self-control. Alright, over on that zone, we get one runner. That should be easy enough to deal with four people standing on the cell. Over here, we get two spawns. One is a runner, the other one's two runners. So we get three runners right next to Clovis. He's going to have to be able to move away in addition to killing those guys. Let's go ahead and let Clovis do some stuff. Alright, we're back to the player turn. First thing we're going to do is activate Clovis with his four dice. And he's going to try to put down that necromancer to close that zone. 5 and 5. That's two kills. He'll take the necro and a unique zombie. So that's two experience. He was at 5, now he's at 7. So he has three actions left. His next action is going to be an attack. Oh, we can close this zone now. His next action is an attack. He kills one. Gets another experience. His next action is going to have to be an attack. Doesn't have to be, but I want it to be. He kills another unique zombie. Gets another experience. And for his final action, he will move right here. And hope the runners don't get double activations, because then he's dead. Really gotta learn the self-control. Alright. Way over there, who has the hammer right now? Anne. Anne's going to attack two times, probably a third time. Success and success. She kills both of these. So all that has been cleared, and she gets 2 experience. So she is now at 5. We're in pretty good shape. So now what we're going to do is... one person is going to go ahead and run over here. 1, 2, pick this up. It's red. My girl that's in red had 2 experience before. She picked up the wrong objective and gets 5 experience points for it. So she is now at 7 experience points. This means she gets another activation. So with her next activation, she's going to move away from this big scary A-bomb. Alright. That's her turn. Genevieve is going to move... no, she's going to stay right here to attract attention. So, she's going to move... no, she's not going to move up one. I don't think she's going to do anything with her turn. This is a hard call. We got to get into this building. So, I'm going to go back there to help my buddy. We may have to run from that Minotaur. 1, 2, 3... She's done. Clovis is done. Genevieve is done. Isabel's done. Julian is going to move. 1, 2, 3. Oh, somebody's got to get into that thing over there. So the rest of them are just going to... well, let's get off the dumb cell. Julian's going to move and search. When he does, he finds some apples, and he eats them. So Julian gets 1 more experience. He's now at 3. All right. Anne's already went. Ostakar needs to go. 1. Search. She finds Death Strike. That'll be useful. Now she can do 2 damage as well. With that, she equips Death Strike. Well, she finds Death Strike. Then she trades the sword for her 3rd action to Julian and takes back Mana Blast, puts Mana Blast in her bag, and then puts Deathstrike in her hand. So now she's ready to blow stuff up again. Alright, I shouldn't have left Anne by herself in that cell. Alright. And all the players are done. The zombies get to move. 1, 2... These guys want to go to the loudest noise, so this way, this way, this way. Later he's going to have to cut into the building. Loudest noise is that way. The shortest path to the loudest noise. Well, they go here, and then their next activation, they move there. Alright, now let's go ahead and do spawns. Way over at the end, we get a double spawn on Anne. Anne's not having a good day. She can't get off that square. 1 runner, 2 walkers. Alright, our final spawn is going to be a double spawn way back at the front. An Abomitrol and a Fatty. The Abomitrol gets a free turn, but he's locked in the cell, so nothing happens. And a Fatty. I was mixed on if I should have left the activation cards for Abomitrols in there for spawning. I chose to in case we open the vault door and for some reason we do something dumb. It would be cool for him to activate and kill us for it. So I'm kind of mixed on if I should have left those Abomitrol cards in there. They didn't tell you to pull the Abomination cards, so I'm guessing you do. Alright, I'm done spawning. So the first thing we're going to do is... Clovis is going to sweep his swords around and clean that up. So Clovis is going to use his 4 dice. He gets enough kills. So Clovis gets 2 kills. 1, 2. That's his first action. His second action is here. His third action is here. His next action is to open the door. And we're going to hope there's not an abomination in there. 6, he succeeds in opening the door. He makes a sound. And I'm going to spawn from the back going forward. Alright, right here, we get 2 walkers. That's not bad. Here, we get a double spawn. A double spawn protecting the objective that we know is there. One extra activation, all standard walkers. That's going to kill Anne. So, let's go ahead and finish this double spawn real quick, and then I'll figure out what to do. Three. The three walkers are after the extra activation. So these three don't get the extra activation. And then I'll have to spawn this room still. But before they go, Ostakar gets her zombie link. So since she's got her zombie link, let's go ahead and take care of her. She feels bad for Anne. So she's going to move back over here for her first action. She shouldn't have traded away that sword. I guess the first thing she does is... yeah, she moves here. She trades Anne Deathstrike for the sword, for the hammer. Now she has two attacks, so she's going to attack twice. One kill. That at least helps. So, one kill for her two attacks. And now her turn is done. Now they get the free activation. Their free activation, we'll go ahead and let her get bit. I won't put any more wounds on her now. But that was her free activation. So now what we need to do is move the rest of the walkers. These count as walkers. These count as walkers. These guys were spawned before that, so they get to move. Now I spawn the final room. The final room is a necromancer, which gives us another spawn point. So let's put the necro here. Let's put his spawn zone down. Let's spawn for him and see what he gets. Two runners. It's a really bad spot for two runners. Alright. I think that's really bad for my characters. One, two, three. I'll help share the wealth and wounds because we know a lot of them are coming. Alright. So I've activated Clovis. I've activated Genevieve. Clovis was my first one to move. So I'm now going to activate Ostakar for her real turn. And that's going to be to attack. She's at least going to attack twice. Two kills. One, two. Her third action will be to trade the hammer back for her spell. Then she's going to cast Death Strike on that one thing she can see. She succeeds. She gets another experience point. And this walker is dead, and that finishes out her turn. She had an amazing turn. My other characters need to be careful. So, we're going to get ready to hightail it. Everybody else is going to move over there to back them up. But before I do that, let's go ahead and see what we can do. So, Ostakar is done. Let's go ahead and draw. Julian's going to search. Finds plenty of arrows, doesn't care. And then he moves on to this cell, getting everybody out of that building before the really scary guy gets there. Alright, Isabel's going to search. She finds healing. She can use it once per turn. That's amazing. She puts it in her offhand. She moves over here, and then she heals Ostakar 1 point. Every turn, we're going to be doing awesome, because now we have healing. Alright, we are done. We have to move into the zombies' turn. Everybody wants to go over there unless they can see something. So, one, 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 one. Double move. Single move. Now, two bites come in. I'm going to put one on Clovis. I'm going to put one on Genevieve. But we have to clean house next turn. Alright. Now, we get to do our spawns. This spawn's still here, unfortunately. Hoping it's not an abomination. So, let's run through everything else. Way over here, we get one extra activation, all walkers. Before that, this person gets to move. One, two, three, four. Walkers. Alright, let's move around the board. Over here, we get 4 NPC zombies. Maybe I should have stayed there to help my friends. But you can't second-guess everything forever. That big abomination's coming, and they gotta get out of there. Alright, way over here, we get 1 spawn. Oh. Which is 2 walkers. This cell's hyper full. It's not good. Here we get a double spawn. So going way back over here, we get a double spawn. It's going to be really hard to get into this vault. That's the only thing I see hard for this mission. And if you choose to level up early all the time, that's a bad thing. 2 walkers and an NPC. NPC, 2 walkers. Alright, we finally made it through the zombie turn. Now we have to start trying to clean house. There's a lot of attacks that need to be made. We're going to start with Clovis, because he's pretty good at dropping things. So, here's his first attack. His first attack is 3 kills. So, let's move Clovis over here. It's going to be the Necro. 1, 2, 3. He's going to drop the Necro and the 2 runners. Might be pushing into orange already, but I don't have a choice. Alright, this guy's gonna attack again. He gets 3 kills. 1, 2, 3. Puts him at 17. If I break into orange, things are gonna get really scary really fast, and I'm not sure I can do a whole lot about it. This is gonna seem dumb, but what he's gonna have to do, I think he's gonna have to hand over his swords. So he's gonna hand his swords for his third action over to Genevieve. And she's gonna hand him the shortbow. Now, with his fourth action, he's gonna shoot the shortbow at the cell. He succeeds, he gets a kill, but he doesn't level, which is important, because he's right at the tippy-tip-tip. So that could have been a dumb decision. Now Genevieve, dual-wielding swords, is going to activate and try to clean house. Alright, so Genevieve attacks. 4 and a 5. She's successful. Alright, so she gets 2 experience. 1, 2. For her next action, she's going to trade her swords back to Clovis for the bow, and then she's going to fire the bow at that zombie. She succeeds. She is at 6 experience now. And this whole building's clean. As long as we don't get some really bad luck, we're going to be doing some fun stuff soon. Don't think I needed a noise token there. Alright. So we took care of that side of the board. Ostakar is maybe going to have to move back into that cell to spread wounds. So let's go ahead and activate this girl. She's going to go ahead and heal herself. That's her first action. She's got 3 actions left. They're all going to be attack. She fails. It's not what I was looking for. Alright. Julian's going to activate, and he's going to triple attack, and hope it goes better than that. 1 kill. That's at least something. So he gets an experience. Alright. Anne will get to activate. She has a hammer, but she doesn't need a hammer, but there's no way to get her multiple attacks right now. So she's going to activate and attack 3 times. Come on. Oh, she cleaned house. Good work, Anne. 3 kills. So looks like she's stacking up the different models. 1 more model and she gets a relic. She gets 3 experience, taking her to 8 experience. And since she's at 8 experience, she gets another action. Her next action is going to be to start trying to get out of here. No, she's going to stay there. That way it's easy to know where the heaviest noise is, and then we'll book it soon. Okay. Now, my final character to activate is going to be my character that's coming in for the backup. 1, 2. She's going to death strike this cell next turn. Alright, and the players are done. Since the players are done, let's see what the zombies do. They move forward. Alright, not so bad. Alright, we gotta do our spawns. We're gonna hope that we get a lot of luck. We got a necromancer way over there, which is gonna be really hard to deal with. I don't know what we're gonna do about that since we can't get around the A-bomb. So we get a necromancer here. He gets a spawn zone, which immediately spawns something. Watch it be the abomination. I fear the abomination, but he's not coming onto the field right now. And I'm probably just going to have to ignore that necros and run. The abomator gets a free turn. We get to choose which way he comes. So I don't want him blocking our path out, so he's going to break through this wall. Yeah, it seems kind of cheap. But I don't know. We can't use that building for hiding. He's going to move straight into the street. We're gonna be into trouble. That's how we're going to do this. Our guys are in trouble now. Alright, way over here we get 3 walkers. Be really hard to deal with 3 walkers without leveling. So I think we're just gonna have to deal with them, grab the stuff, and try to get into that vault. I like that the game is interesting right now, but I also don't like it's interesting. Alright, so I think we've taken care of everything we need to take care of. Now we can move into the player turn. First thing we're gonna do is Clovis is gonna work his magic, because I don't have a choice. So Clovis is finally going to push into orange level. So 4 dice. This is his first action. He kills all 3 zombies. We are now in orange. He is at 21. So that was not fun. He gets a free melee attack, but he has 3 normal actions left. And it's going to be 1, 2, 3. She has 3 actions. 1, 2. She takes the objective. Oh, it's the blue objective. Who would have thought? So she has the blue objective, and she gets 5 experience, pushing her to 11. Let me double check something. Seems weird to only have 4 things you gotta search. Yeah, that's the way it is. All right, making sure I didn't miss one. So now she gets an extra action for her final action. She's going to search. She finds a short bow. You can't dual wield short bows. So we put down the short bow. Okay, Clovis has activated, so has Genevieve. Walkers have targeting priority, so I'm going to attack the walkers here. Miss, miss. Hit 1. So all 4 attacks went out. I hit 1, so she kills another walker. She has a 3rd type in her cell now. She gets 1 experience. And I think she's just going to hang out there to draw attention so my other guys can go to the end of the game. Everybody else is going to go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. Oh, wait. Did I activate these characters already this turn? They cleaned house. Oh, their spawn was the Abomator. I did. I did not activate them. 1, 2, 3. So we've set up for a really good spot just to go claim everything and be done. So now we are done with the player's turn. and it seems like a little silly for them to book it and run, but at least here I can control where the abomator is going because I've made the most sound. I can control where everything's going. Everything's going here. Alright, we're going to just break that door down and run out that door and start killing stuff as long as it's not abomination right there. So I think that was a pretty good setup, and hopefully those stock R doesn't get hit. Really hoping to heal somebody, but don't think that's needed. So I guess I'm done. All the zombies moved. Oh yeah, of course I'm done because I've already moved zombies. I was just looking over if I messed something up. Let's go ahead and run spawns. Way over there we get two spawns. Abomatrol gets a free turn. Necro now gets two activations a turn. Alright. So way over there we get a fatty. And over here we get one fatty. Oh, we're in orange. Because Clovis cleaned house. So I need to backtrack. Okay. Abomator, Necro. This other thing, instead of being a fatty, would have been four walkers, and the next one is four walkers. So, Necro, Abomator, four walkers. I almost forgot what range I was in. Alright, she's gonna have a hard time running from those guys, but at least she bought everybody time. Alright, Clovis is going to try to open this door. So for our turn, we're going to go ahead and activate Clovis first. Clovis wants out. Four. He broke open the door. One, two, three. Clovis is almost there to help out. He gets a free melee action, but I don't think I can count opening the door as a melee action. One, two, three. Alright, and we are done. There was an extra noise right there. These people can see stuff. They'll move on to Clovis. Now I'm going to go ahead and go with my girl that's red. She's going to open this door. She's going to open this door. So, open, open. Alright. Now, Anne's gonna go. One. Alright, let me mark who's all moved so I don't mess this up. Clovis, Genevieve, Axe Girl. Anne moves one down, trades her hammer for the axe. Oh, hold on. Isabel might have a fourth action. She leveled earlier. Let's go back to Isabel. So, Isabel, open, open, move, open, move. She goes ahead and moves in here. Anne moves one, two. She trades for the axe for her third action. Then she opens the vault. So, sorry, I'm trading stuff right now. All right. Then, for her fourth action, she opens the vault, which makes some noise. Alright, Julian's gonna go one, two, three. Julian hasn't leveled, so he can't pick those up, but we're about to have everything we need to beat the game. Alright, so I have one character left to activate. One, two, three, four. Alright, I think we're good. Sorry, I had to check the phone. And now I've dropped a die. Alright, I really think things are going well. I think this is going to still end up being a short mission like I had originally hoped. But that necromancer is going to run really fast. So I don't think I'm going to be able to catch him. And soon we'll have four permanent zones. So, zombies move. There's no choice. It doesn't matter where they're going. That's where they're going. Now, these four, I'll work my way around the board, go here. This guy moves up. These guys move to the noisiest place, which is now here. They're going this way. Noisiest, since he can't see anything. Noisiest. They can see something, so they move this way. All right, things are looking pretty good. The two spawns right next to me are going to be... Those are searches. The two spawns right next to me are going to be 9 walkers. Oh my gosh. That's a lot of walkers. I don't know that we can deal with 9. Clovis, get over here. Clovis is the only person that can deal with that many walkers. Alright. The next zone is going to be an abomination. He's going to kind of get in the way of doing what I need to do. It's going to make it harder to get to this purple vault. Wow, it's a lot of stuff on the board now. Over here, we get 2 fatties. Oh, the necromancer gets 2 turns, so he's actually here. Alright, so I think we're doing pretty... Well, we were doing pretty good until an army spawned. I think we can still do some interesting stuff with this. Clovis is just going to have to work on getting over there, because, yeah... Clovis is the only one that can handle that stuff. So, moving forward. I'm going to pick up the fire and the torch. That's his first action. So, his first action is grab these things. One, two, and... He's going to keep the torch. He's going to hold the bio in his bag. So that's his first action. And then, I think what I have to do is, I don't know. I kind of want everybody to hop into this thing with me. He's definitely got to do that. I think everybody's going to start dying. Alright, I think he's just going to stay in his little hut right now. So he's going to remain hidden in his vault, because he's scared. He's like, oh, what's going on up there? Oh no, I'm just going to hang out here, okay guys? Alright, Clovis has got to work magic now. So, Clovis, please start working some magic. So the first thing Clovis does is try to kill some of these walkers on his cell. Alright, he kills 3. That's a good start. That's his free action. So, 1, 2, 3. Alright, he's going to have to attack again. Kills 1. That's all he needed. So that was his first real action. His second action, now his third action... Kills 1. Now he gets to do his final 4th action, which is clean up the rest. So he gets another sculpt, and he just killed 3 guys off that cell. 1, 2, 3. And Clovis worked some magic. There's still some more magic that needs to be run. But that was a really decent turn. I would really like to get those walkers out of the way, so that my other characters could do something. So I'm going to go ahead and activate Genevieve. Genevieve's going to move forward. 1, 2. And she's going to shoot the fatty. We're hoping the walkers don't get an extra activation, because then my 2 characters are dead. So 1, 2, shoot the fatty. Success. The fatty's gone, so we don't have to worry about the fatty. 1 more experience. Alright, those 9 walkers are pretty scary. And things are going to spawn after that. I really should have took him up. If I had taken him up 1, I might have a chance. She's going to move one, two, three. That's all her actions. She's going to just kind of bring those guys into the building and try to, like, do some sort of crazy maneuver and get out. Pretty sure it's not going to happen. But, Anne, what's Anne going to do? I don't want those guys to split up. Or actually, do I want them to split up? Alright, we're going to hop into the vault with him. I think that's the right move. No, it's not the right move. Somebody has to die. Because I can't have it split up, and I can't have Clovis die right now, and us not be able to clean that square. So somebody's going to have to take one for the team. Who's it going to be? Isabel's nowhere close to 3 damage. But if she gets there, she can start saving things. So, let's put Anne in first and see how bad things are. I think I forgot to shoot once with Genevieve. But can't go back. So Anne's going to bloodlust over with the axe. So, she'll get at least 3 attacks, and we're going to see how that goes. Miss, miss, miss. Alright. You know what? I'm going to stay up here. Because that's the closest spot to the action, and I need to get in the action quickly. This is bad. Guess I'm going to start losing people. So, alright, time to start moving zombies. The loudest noise is over there. They don't worry about loudest noise. These do. Necromancer's almost out. They all bite Anne. And Anne's gone. That was very unfortunate. So now what we have to do is work spawns. We're hoping not a whole lot of scary stuff spawns there. An abomination gets a free turn. And the second spawn is going to be 4 NPCs. So that cell has 13 zombies on it. That is ridiculous. Alright, let's go way over there. Way over there, we get 5 walkers. We got a clean house on those walkers, because soon they're gonna start getting extra activations. Alright, way over here, we get 1 abomination, so we get another fresh abomination on the field. This mission's fun. I really shouldn't have pushed the levels like I do, but, you know, that's what I do. So we move into a player turn. The players are actually gonna get some turns. And we're going to put everything in on that cell. So Julian's going to move 1, 2. I don't know. Hold on. We're not going to activate Julian. Let's get Anne out of the way. She almost made it to getting an artifact. Clovis will go ahead and get one, though. But before he starts trying to get an artifact, let's see, there are 4 different sculpts over there, do I? Yeah, there's 4 sculpts there. Genevieve's gonna go ahead and go, and she's gonna fire 4 rounds into the cell to start cleaning things. This should help. Come on, 2 kills. It's something. I mean, hitting on 3s, I should have done better than that. But she gets 2 experience. 1, 2. And she is done. We're going to wait for Julian to go. We really want him to go later, so that cell might be clean by that time. Alright, Clovis is going to use his first action to go here. Now he has 4 attack actions. He's got to kill a lot of stuff. So, 4 attack actions. First attack action. 1. He takes this guy, he trades in for a relic. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's hope it's something worthwhile. There are some cool things in here. He has 3 attacks left. orcish crossbow. That's good, if I can get it to Genevieve. Alright, so he's got 3 attacks left. He kills 1. This is not looking real good. So he killed 1 before. So I've killed 2. He's got 2 attacks left. Come on! 2 more go away. He gets 2 more experience. He's got 1 attack left. It's gotta be good. He kills 2 more. Okay, those are normal zombies. That was not what I was looking for. 1, 2. It's a lot of zombies on that square. That's 5 damage coming in at least. That's going to be really hard to split up. I might have to let somebody get eaten again. I don't want it to be Clovis, though. He's awesome. Alright. So, now, Isabel's going to move in for 1 action. She will trade to borrow the 2 swords. That's 2 actions. She's got 2 left. She's going to trade over healing to Clovis. And she will get 4 attacks. Okay, she kills 2 more. That's going to help. 1, 2. Julian's going to go ahead and come out. 1, 2. With his 3rd action. What's Julian got? He's got a sword. He's going to attack. Oh, the orcish crossbow is still in Clovis's inventory. Oh, when he did that, he's going to keep healing out. Alright, come on, Julian. Show me what you're worth. Nothing. Miss. Alright. That was a really, really bad turn. Now we're going to move 1, 2, 3, 4. We're going to go ahead and start trying to attract some attention. Maybe that could help things out. Alright, bad guys are going to go. 3 damage comes in on this cell, so we got to deal with that first. Isabel will take 2. Clovis will take 1. I don't want anybody dying yet. So that's decent. We're still alive, and we still have our hammer, which is cool. This big guy moves here. Alright. These guys move here. These guys move here. Necro leaves, makes his zone permanent. I'm glad it's permanent with all this stuff here. That's great. Alright. These guys move towards the noisiest. And I get to choose how they want to go. Ones that definitely have to go that way. This guy ignores walls, so I'm going to take his path that way and just blow through some stuff. Alright. These guys move to the noise, noise, noise. Now what we need to do is spawn, and let's hope it's not really bad things that happen. 4 NPCs on this square. At least we have a chance at getting another artifact. What else on that square? 6 NPCs. Yeah. We might be dead. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I don't know Clovis can work that much magic. 2 runners way over here. At least we get some free artifacts. And if Genevieve gets that orcish crossbow, our problems are solved. All these scary things will die. Alright, 1 more, and we get 2 runners. Not scared about stuff happening all the way on the other side of the board. Okay, we get our turns. The first thing we're going to do is I can't afford to waste time healing. Isabel has 4 actions. So that should be 8 dice total. So, she's going to take 6 dice, and then trade with Clovis. Come on. She's going to take out three normal walkers. One, two, three. So she's at 12 experience. All right, then her last action is she trades these to Clovis, saying, "You know what to do." Now that Clovis has his weapons, he has four actions, one free melee action. He's going to work on cleaning house. Because that's what Clovis does. He saved so many missions for me, he can save this one too. Alright. So, the first action I have to take is... attacks. Lots and lots and lots of attacks. So, I have to do 5 rounds of this. I'll count up the bodies later. So, this is my first action. I'm counting these on my fingers. 2 go away. Alright. Second action. 2 go away. Third action. 1 goes away. Fourth action. Well, let's trade in. That was 3 actions. So he's got 5 different sculpts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're going to go ahead and get an artifact. The artifact he gets is the Orcus shortbow. He goes ahead and stocks that. So he's got 2 actions left. Two kills. So 2 more. We're working on getting another artifact. His final action, his 5th attack, is to clean more house. He gets 2 more. Nope, I'm not going to take this one. I'm going to take that one. So I get another sculpt. I trade in and see what I get. Oh, crap. How many did I kill? Okay. I think he killed about 10. Yeah, because he traded in. Regardless, he at least killed... yeah, he killed about 10. So, I don't want him to be in red, but just since I put some away, we're going to say he killed 10. So that puts us in red, which is scary. So he's cleaned house. Now what we need to do is trade in for the other artifact, which hopefully is going to be something really cool. The heavy crossbow. Alright, the heavy crossbow does 3 damage, which is amazing. But he's done. Isabel is done. Julian could go. Ostakar is going to probably stay where she's at. She's going to go ahead and cast Death Strike. She's going to stay at this in order to clear the path for Julian. Alright. So she rolls some dice. She kills 3 of these guys. She gets 3 experience. 1, 2, 3. And she makes 4 noise. Well, she is a noise, so now there's 4 noise in the square. Alright. Genevieve's going to spend 2 actions. 1, 2. No, I don't know. Somebody's got to clean this square. Julian's going to attempt to do it. Julian trades the torch and bile to Clovis for the 2 swords. No, he trades the torch and bile to Clovis, which Clovis puts in his bag. Actually... the torch and bile are going to end up on... I guess he's got to keep them. He trades with Isabel for the hammer and healing. Now he has hammer and healing. So he's going to attack the zombie on his square. Success. He kills it. He's at 5 experience. He's got 1 action left. And he's the guy with the cool stuff. Oh, he traded. He gave her the sword. He's got 1 action left. He needs to heal somebody. No, he's got 1 action left. He needs to move away. He needs to protect himself. He's what's keeping us going. He's got the bile and the torch. Alright. Genevieve's going to move 1. She's going to ask for the orcish crossbow and the heavy crossbow. So this is her second action. She takes the orcish crossbow and the heavy crossbow as a backup. And she puts the short bow in the bag with the other short bow. So she's going to fire her orcish crossbow at the A-bomb now that she can do 3 damage. She kills it. She gets 5 experience. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. She levels. She gets a extra range die now. So, 1 action, trade, 3 actions. 4 actions. No, 4 actions she wouldn't be able to shoot. Alright. Yeah, 4 actions. She's going to keep things busy there. Alright, the noisiest cell is here. The fastest path there is this guy's going to break right through the door. There won't be a door anymore. This character's going to move here. This character's going to move here. These two move here. These all move this way. Alright, and let's see. This guy's here, here, moving towards the heaviest noise, moving towards the heaviest noise. She's helping out a lot by making all that racket. I should be able to just walk across the board, hopefully, now. We got a lot of good gear. And Clovis can hand this orcish bow, which is amazing, to somebody, too. As long as we're still alive in a little bit. Alright, so now let's go ahead and work spawns. There's no noise here. All this noise is going to dissipate. Oh, I guess we don't have to worry about that yet, because we could get extra activations. So, let's see. An abomination gets a free turn. It attacks and does 1 damage to Genevieve. She's now taken one. She only has 1 more health left. Alright, what else spawns in the cell is 1 fatty. Good, thanks. Well, I don't know that we can actually deal with that, but we can walk away from it. Alright, our fine... The Abomitrol, nothing happens. Our final spawn point is going to be a 5 walkers. I hate all the walkers on the board. Alright, we haven't made it through the entire spawn pile yet. We get a turn. Since we get a turn, I'm going to go ahead and activate Genevieve first. Can anybody on the cell that can actually deal with that fatty? Let's just say no. So nobody can deal with that fatty. So 1, 2, 3. Not unless those runners are gone. So actually, we're going to see if my mage can deal with those runners. So she's not planning on going anywhere. Unless things go really, really well for her. She gets 4 dice. She misses every time. That's her turn. Alright. Everybody else is going to start making their way to that door. 1, 2. They'll wait. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hey guys! What's going on? Alright. So Genevieve has 4 actions. First thing she wants to do is put down the Abomitrol. So she gets 3 attack dice, and she's using her orcish crossbow. 3s or higher. She puts down the Abomitor, Abomination. So she's killed that, and she gets 5 experience for killing this. I need to go back. I don't know what I spawned last. Two runners. Alright. I messed up one of my spawns. 5 walkers was right. 1 fatty. This should be 3 fatties here. Because I'm in the red range. So everything else I think was good because it was extra activations and stuff. So I think that should take care of everything. There should be 3 guys there because Clovis went to the red level with all those kills. So that should clean things up. Instead of being 5 walkers, that was supposed to be 5 walkers. So I think we're good now. So she attacked. She could reload. But instead of reloading, she's going to use the heavy crossbow from now on. So she doesn't have to reload. She's going to take 3 shots, needing 4s or higher. This is her second action. All right here. So 2. She gets 2 kills. That's her second action. 1, 2. She's going to shoot at that cell again. This is her third action. Success. She killed the fatty. All right. For her fourth action, she's going to toss 3 dice at the zombies in front of her. 1 kill. So she kills 1 walker. That's another experience. Alright, so we should be good here. Alright, unfortunately, I don't think Ostakar is going to make it. But, oh, she cast 4 times, so there should be 4 noise there. That's what everybody's interested in. So, 1. A lot of guys right here. She doesn't make it. The runners end up here. And these end up on her. Alright, so now we just have to run spawns, and for running those spawns, let's see, gotta run the spawns, sorry. Alright, the 2 behind my girl over there is a necromancer and 5 NPCs, and the necromancer spawn's gonna generate 6 walkers. So, 4, 5, 6. 6 walkers, a necromancer, and 5 NPCs. We've gotten all our relics, so I'm going to go ahead and... What am I doing? So we got all our relics. I'm going to go ahead and trade stuff in. I can't get anything for it. So let's just replenish that pile. All right. For our next spawn, we got to shuffle. So this mission should be over relatively shortly. I think it's pretty good, except the troll, we're going to have to let him get an activation to get out of that cell. Because I don't think I can get anybody in there and throw the fire. Let's see. 1, 2, if it's already open. 3, no line of sight out, so he's going to have to torch it with himself inside. All right. So let's go ahead and spawn for the zone right in front of us. The Abomator gets a free activation and starts heading there. Which is good, kind of. So let's go ahead and see what we can get done. Way over here, we're going to get 6 walkers. I'm about to be out of walkers, so I got to start dealing with that. Alright, we've made it into a player turn. The first thing I want to do is Genevieve's going to use her orcish crossbow. She gets 2 kills. So she's used 1 of her actions. 1, 2. Alright. 3. Oh. 1 action. 2nd action. 3rd action. A heavy crossbow can hit from here. I'm going to take 2 shots. Sorry. 1, 2, 3. I'm going to take 1 shot at that cell. So it's going to be the heavy crossbow because the orcish crossbow is not loaded. And we're hoping to drop that abomination. So I get a 6, and that's all I get. So that's a kill. That guy's down, so she gets 5 experience. She's at 30. And her turn is done. Ostakar is dead, so let me move her away. Alright, now what we need to do is We need to move over into the vault. One, two, one, two, one, one, two. All right. And I think we get to call it a turn. Because we're not opening the vault while there's crazy stuff there. And I don't want to let that abomination out. So, I think we call it a turn, and we move everybody. Huge wave of junk moves. Alright, these guys move. These guys move. These guys move. These guys move. Oh, sorry. Those guys would end up there. These guys still end up there, I believe. Wait, one, two. Maybe they're... I don't remember where these guys were. I think they got an extra move, so I think they're there. Okay, this guy's here, this guy's here, this is here. This is there, here. Alright, we should be good now. We just hope runners don't get an extra activation, because then my bow girl's gone. Okay. Oh! When the necromancer spawned, I did his spawn, but I didn't put it down. Okay, so we gotta do three spawns right there. We're gonna get a necro, so the necro gets another action on his next turn. Four NPCs. One, two, three, four. Alright, for the third one, we're gonna get three runners. That doesn't cause a runner spawn. We are way ahead of runners. Walkers, we're not. We get some stuff here. And it's gonna be two fatties. So, two fatties are gonna be over here. Alright, over here, we're gonna run into another necromancer. The next necromancer gets... The necromancer is going to get triple activations in a second. So that's going to move him way too fast. I don't think Genevieve could do anything about that. So Isabel's going to try to open up that door. I'm not sure about like sending somebody down in there to die in a fire. So hopefully I don't mess up the game doing this. But I'm going to go ahead and open up the door. Five, success, the vault's open. Alright, player turn is done. The A-bomb moves out. That happens. Then this happens. Then he bites her. She is now dead. Oh, let me put Anne's body on the board. I don't know where Anne is, but she went down over there. Alright, so that happened. The runners will end up way over here. These guys end up here. Alright, now I got a spawn for all the zones. There are three spawns over there. Abomator. Five walkers. This is what I was worried about. I didn't want to have to send people down there and just like sacrifice themselves to kill that Abomatrol, but I really was afraid of the extra activations. So five walkers, an Abomator. The Abomatrol gets three actions. For those three actions, he's going to... Okay, he bites Julian twice. Then he bites Isabel, and Isabel's gone. Alright, over here, we get a spawn of five walkers. One, two, three, four, five. And our final spawn zone... Don't be an Abomatrol. Oh, good, five walkers. Five walkers. I can't place them. Oh, Clovis is still up. Good. Isabel was the one that didn't make it. Five walkers. I can put one. Let's look everywhere and make sure I didn't mess up the walkers. Two, three. Alright, so remember I didn't want to do the glory thing and send somebody into the vault and just go ahead and lose them. That's what's gonna have to happen, because now things have really hit the fan. So all the walkers get a free move. Free move. Each mission, it seems like I have a few less people alive at the end. Alright, so Isabel died. We're moving into our turn. Clovis is gonna have to go and do really well. I'm running out of options. This is his free attack action. Come on, 2 kills. It's his first action. He's already at max, so it doesn't matter. That's his free action. Now we're gonna take his... Oh! I forgot to give him his other thing. +1 to dice roll. I believe that was a 2, so he killed 1. Alright, his second action. He's going to... +1 to dice roll combat. He hits on 3s. He kills the last 2. He's got 3 actions left. Those were his 2 free... Oh, sorry. He's got... Yeah, 3 actions left. For his 3 actions, he already has his stuff. He goes 1, 2, 3, picks up the Dwarven Shield, which would have been nice to have earlier. Alright, his turn's done. Julian is going to try to be epic. He equips Dragon Bile for his first action. He goes with the torch, and since I was trying not to send someone down in the vault and do something stupid, I end up having to do something stupid. I drop the bile here. As my second action, I drop the torch. Julian doesn't make it. At least the epicness was worthwhile. I killed the troll, completing one part of my quest, and now we move into the zombie turn. Everybody moves. 3. I believe you can't have more than 6. So, I can't get another spawn zone. Alright. Move. Now I run spawns. So 3 spawns. Fatties. So 5 fatties. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The next thing is going to spawn 2 because of a double spawn. So I have 3 spawns left. 7 walkers, so walkers get a free activation. 2 fatties. So walkers get a free activation. 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 That was for that one. I have 1 more zone left. It's going to be a double spawn. It's horrible. Way over there. 5 walkers. Walkers get a free activation. Walkers get a free activation. Free activation. Free activation. Free activation. Free activation. Okay, the double spawn is going to be an abominatrol. Oh my gosh, I was so hoping it wasn't going to be another walker, because then they would have been in the pit with me, and I'm not sure I could pick it up. Alright, the abominatrol's back up, way over here. We get our turn. We pick up the relic. It's Inferno, and he doesn't really have anywhere to go, so I'm not sure how this counts as a win, but it is a win. We have all the relics, and we have killed the abomination. Inferno is left over. I wonder what the next card would have been. NPCs, we still would have been good. Alright, that was fun. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. Alright, later.